Hey there! Have you ever wondered how your daily choices contribute to climate change? Then you are at the right place. In this video, we will explore the concept of a carbon footprint and its impact on the health of our planet. Let's find out what it means, why it is important, and how you can calculate and reduce your own footprint. Are you ready? Let's go! In order to get a better understanding about the carbon footprint, we will first look at its definition. In essence, a carbon footprint is a measure of the total greenhouse gas emissions that are directly or indirectly associated with an individual, product, organization, or event. Simply explained, it includes all emissions that are released during the execution of activities such as energy consumption, transportation, manufacturing, or waste management. Compiling and assessing a carbon footprint is perhaps more important than you think. It helps to identify the most polluting activities, also known as high-impact areas. The idea behind this is that it enables individuals and companies to take appropriate measures and minimize the environmental impact, but also to encourage them to take collective action and embrace sustainable initiatives to tackle the pressing challenges of global warming and secure healthy ecosystems. The importance of a carbon footprint cannot be overstated, and therefore it is essential to explore the three scopes, each representing different levels of emissions. Scope 1 refers to direct greenhouse gas emissions from owned or controlled sources. This could be from a car or machine, but also from a facility. Scope 2 encompasses indirect emissions resulting from the generation of purchased electricity, steam, and gas. These emissions occur off-site but are linked to the energy you consume. Scope 3 includes all other indirect emissions that occur in your value chain, both upstream and downstream. This category covers emissions from the supplier, transportation, and waste disposal. Now we know almost everything about the carbon footprint, we will take a look into the calculation, which involves a few important steps. Step 1. Define the scope. In this step, we have to decide whether the calculation of the carbon footprint is for an individual, organization, product, or event. Step 2. Collect data. After selecting the right entity, we need to collect data on relevant activities. This might include energy consumption, transportation, and waste generation. Step 3. Use emission factors. When the data is collected, we have to convert it into carbon emissions using standard emission factors. These factors express the amount of CO2 equivalent emitted per unit of activity. Step 4. Apply the calculation. For each category, multiply the activity data by the corresponding emission factors. Step 5. Analyze and interpret the results. Once you have calculated the carbon footprint, analyze the results to identify areas for reduction. After calculating and analyzing the carbon footprint, you are ready to take action and reduce it. Some effective strategies that you can use are: energy efficiency. Utilize smart technology to monitor energy use and implement saving measures such as insulation, double glazing, or motion sensors. Renewable energy. Invest in renewable energy sources like solar panels, wind turbines, or biomass to reduce your reliance on fossil fuels. Sustainable transportation. Make use of an electric vehicle, public transportation, or get around by bike or on foot. Waste reduction. Implement recycling in your daily life. Reduce single-use plastic and compost food scraps to manage waste more sustainably. Are you interested in more strategies to reduce your carbon footprint? Then hit that subscribe button, turn on your notifications, and check out the video at the left side of the screen. Do you prefer to learn more about sustainability in general? Then check out the video at the right side of the screen. Enjoy watching and see you next time!